Hey, welcome back, guys. Today we're talking all about brake barrels. Brake barrels are kind of what got things kicked off. And if it wasn't a brake barrel, it was a cocking or a pump action gun. So you could just pick up your gun, either cock it, pump it, stick a pellet in it or BB and shoot it. And that's what air guns are. That's what we knew. That's what we all grew up with. Red Riders or the Crossman pump guns or whatever they were. They've evolved exponentially and then they've gotten a lot better and a lot more accurate. And so Sig Sauer, M17, Army pistols, MCX, assault rifles. I mean, they have some of the baddest guns on the planet in the firearms world. And they have recently in the past, gosh, probably 2 years, from what I'm kind of aware of, have broken into the air gun market. And this is the ASP20, the Sig Sauer ASP20 brake barrel rifle. And this is their first, introduction to brake barrel rifles. They are very committed to perfection. Literally, their slogan is never settle. And so they've broken into the air gun world, and this is one of the first guns that we've got a chance to see from them, especially on the brake barrel side. This is the first one. So first things first, just looking at it, just a cool looking gun. It's suppressed. This is the beech stock, goes for about 430. There's a synthetic stock you can get for about 350. Got the Picatinny rail, very simple. Big safety, ambidextrous, so you can click the safety from both sides. So that's good. Obviously this works. It's also ambidextrous. It's got a little checkering here and here, but again, pretty simple design. From what I understand though, it's the internals that make it different. Number one, there's an adjustable trigger, a two-stage adjustable trigger from 2.5 pounds to 4 pounds. It's a match light trigger, like on a brake barrel. That's pretty awesome. Also, there's this glide light cocking system. So every time it's this 33-pound cocking system. And then when you get here and you hear it click, then you're used to like holding it down while you load it. But see, it's a free floating arm in here. So like, you actually don't have to do this. You can just cock it and put your pellet in. And if you wanted to stand around and look at birds, you could stand around like this. But there's no chance of it kicking back because it goes kind of in this neutral zone after you cock it, which is pretty cool. And then there you go. Then you cock it. And there's also this glide light system. There's something on the inside of it that makes sure that you don't have any barrel droop. There's a gas ram cocking system on the internals, and it's a good gun. It shoots well, and it comes in 22 and 177. The 22, it shoots about 850 feet per second, a little bit faster than 177. Keeping everything subsonic because that's where you're gonna get the most accuracy. So we're gonna test this thing out. I've been shooting some targets and trying to get dialed in at 25 and 50 and 100. And my groups are at 25, they're all touching. At 50, they're probably 50 cent size, quarter size groups with a brake barrel. Again, that call comes down to how I'm shooting. I'm going artillery hold, so I'm keeping my hand under here and letting it kind of do its thing. But it's a good looking gun, so we're gonna kick things off at 25 yards. There's a balloon out there and there's a circle mint sitting on top of that balloon. We're gonna kick things off here and I'm gonna knock that mint off the balloon without popping the balloon at 25 yards. All right, here we go. Boom! That's what I'm talking about. You want an accurate brake barrel? This is the Sig Sauer ASP20. That was a 25 yards, a mint on a balloon. Yes, there was a little piece of tape there to hold it in place because the wind's blowing, but boop! Mint gone, balloon still there. I know what you're thinking. Wait a second, that wasn't really a balloon. Really? Balloon. Yeah, 73 yards. There's three playing cards. Let's see if we can cut one in half. Yeah, I got it. Yeah! We gotta check this out. Come on. Oh. Yes! Look at that. 75 yards. Now here's what's crazy, right? I started this one. First shot. Right there. And my camera guy's like, shoot at the other one. Can't see it. I'm like, all right, second shot. Right there and nicked the bottom of it. And then the wind picked up. So as you can see, I had this line going and then it switched on me and was hitting over here. I made an adjustment. Bank out of the top. That's 75 yards with a brake barrel. Sig Sauer ASP20. Are you kidding me? Yeah, you know who's wild? Not the Joker. I'm wild, baby! Woo!
You want a brake barrel? Go to AmericanAirGunner.com and buy an ASP-20.
See ya.
Up next, we'll be joining Steve Kreiner for some prairie dog hunting with the Umarex Octane Elite.
This episode of American Air Gunner is brought to you by FX Air Guns, Sig Sauer, MTC Optics, and by Air Force Air Guns. And a special thanks to all these American Air Gunner partners.